A very warm good morning. This is Abhay from Manu Patra Information Solutions. Thank you for joining me for day three of the webinar series. We're doing exclusively for students. It's been a rough few days for all of us. Credit goes to you guys that you are making most of it by learning a new skill. I hope this session will help once things get back to normal. This session will be of 40-45 minutes. So any question you might have, you might write it down and we'll discuss it at the end of the session. So a brief intro about the company. Manu Patra Information Solutions started its journey in the year 2000 as the pioneers of in India. Today we have grown into the largest content aggregator for Indian and international database. We have offices across 22 cities in India. So what has helped us stay relevant after all these years is our singular focus on technology. So we see ourselves as a technology company and not just as a database provider. We use a lot of technological tools like visualization tools, artificial intelligence, editorial enhancement at right places to ensure that our users can see a pattern in the sea of data available today. There's a lot of thought that goes on to how can we make it easier, how can we make it quicker for our user to get to the best result in the least possible time. Okay, with that, let's start with the session. So once you go to Manu Patra or manupatrafast.com, you just have to sign in by your username password. College has an IP subscription, so whenever you are connected to the college Wi-Fi, a button will appear here and you will be able to sign in from there. Now this will be my home screen. On the left hand side is the table of contents and on the right is the different search options. So we already have two sessions, day before yesterday and yesterday, in which the first day we discussed the table of contents. So I went into the length and breadth of the table of contents. Yesterday's session was about the different searches that were available in Manu Patra. Today what we are going to discuss is whatever is left over, and what we are decided is to do a lot of case studies with you guys so that you can get a practical aspect of how to use Manu Patra when you are doing your actual research. Okay, so let me start with legal analytics. So this is available with My Home and Manu Search. Okay, legal analytics. So as I was telling you, we are not just your normal database provider where just you can type the result or you can just look for a printout. Here we do a lot more. We are the only one that's doing this. So I'll just type in my query, gender justice. So this analytical tool, what it does for me is it creates a visualization of top 50 results and it also gives me a relationship. So a lot of people are visual thinkers. So you know, a visual map is very easy to make sense of the data. So often we go to the clients and his question is, what is a landmark judgment on a particular topic? So this is a good way to answer that question. So there are different landmark judgments, and depending on the size of the balloon, you can see that how the size of the balloon denotes that this particular case has been cited more. So this is Dharam versus Sudhir Bhatam, this has been cited 90 plus times. Okay, let's click on a balloon which is smaller in size. Say, let's click on this one. So this is Ruma Chakraborty versus Sudha Rani Banerjee. This has been cited just 21 times. So the more a case has been cited in different courts, the more relevant we think it is. So this is a big balloon. It has been cited 154 plus times. Okay, now let me give you a brief overview of the timeline. So this is from 1980 onwards. You see topics on gender justice slowly have been rising, which is a good news. Okay, when you go up on the y-axis, you will see these are the all high court judgments. Okay, so this is their Madhya Pradesh High Court. And this is Kerala High Court. So these are small because they are not cited that often, but still a very relevant Kerala High Court judgment. Now, when we go further up on the y-axis, you will see these are the all the Supreme Court judgments. Okay. Now, I just click on one, and I'll be able to see where this case, how many times it has been discussed, how many times it has been affirmed, how many times it has been mentioned. The percentage wise also it's given. The relevant keywords according to this case law. So we are giving you a brief synopsis of the editorial enhancements that we provide. So these are keywords that we put in. These are the acts that are not coming in the printed copy. These are we are putting in. So similarly, case notes are also available in different features. Okay. And this is again another one. If you just point to a particular, you will see that there are different lines that are going across. So this means that this particular case has been cited in these many high court cases and even some Supreme Court cases. So this in a sense also gives you a idea of how much relevant it is. So how much of a landmark judgment it is. So there in any judgment you will see that this has been cited and two other judgments have been cited in this one. Okay. Now I found out that this is very good. This is my relevant case. How do I get to this? Okay. Let's click on to this one. It will take me. This is Mukesh and others versus state of NCLT. And this is the case. 10 number. I can just click on this one. And now voila, the case is there. So if I want to read this case, okay. So in many search engines, what happens is once you get to your most relevant result, that and your search is over. Okay. That is not the case with Manu Patra. From there, we are just beginning. So there are many, many features in a particular case note. This particular case that we have put in. Okay. So this is how a case looks in Manu Patra. These are different features. I'll click on each one of them. We have explained this yesterday also, but I won't resist explaining them again. So these are the orders that were, these are the cases that were referred in this case. So everything is hyperlinked. On top of that, any case that is mentioned, there is this wheel sign that is coming in front of it. This you are seeing there also. So this gives me Sudhakar versus state of MP, where this case was discussed, where this was mentioned, relied on. So this is helpful because sometimes I just have a particular judgment's name only. So this gives me more information. What kind of a judgment it is? It is relied more often or is it just to check on the quality of the judgment? You can see from here. Again, if it was challenged by any other Supreme Court case, this is again, it's provided. And prior history is also there. So if a particular case, where it was coming from, this is a New Delhi High Court case. So Delhi High Court case was there. So you get the entire history of the case and the what happened to the case afterwards. So you're getting a lot of things here. Now these are the citing references again. So among those cases which I just showed you that were cited in this case, how many cases were affirmed? How many of those cases were just relied? The one case that is relied, and how many were discussed? So you get a lot of more judgments to read from here. You know, the relevant for you, you know, if you want to see, if you find this one very helpful, you can find another judgment that it relied on. So this is the case note. Different judge wise, we have organized this. First one was from Deepak Mishra. So this is the judgment. This is also hyperlink particular that name. So hyperlinking is one thing that you will find comprehensively here. So any section that is mentioned that will be hyperlinked. So very small feature you'll say, but not a lot of softwares are doing this. So it's very helpful to jump from one judgment to another. Say a particular case law is mentioned in this, you can jump into that. If a particular notification is mentioned, you can jump into that. So everything is provided to you. So similarly, this case, Ratan Singh versus the state of Himachal Pradesh, you can just click on to this one. And it will take you to the relevant case here. Okay. Now again, One simple feature is copy paste that you can from here. Just we're back. All this is hyperlinked. Now, if you go back to the top of the judgment, different things available. So I quickly click on to these features. So this is Manu citation. Once you click on to this one, this will give me an equivalent citation. So we have more than 320 journals that we cover equivalent citations from. So be it Scale, SEC, AIR. So all the journals are available from one. So like from volume one till volume that has come pages. So you go to like Senior Advocate's home and you see a big library there. That is all available and much more. Okay. Now, this is another feature. This is a print replica. So print replica is what we are giving you is the code copy from the judgment. So this is available in all the judgments. So this is as reported by Judis. Sometimes what happens is a lot of publishers, what they're doing is they're changing the paragraph for the particular judgment. We don't do that. That is basically tampering with the judgment. But you can always go to the source text. So source text, all the document that is available in Manupatra, that will be provided. So you can go and check for yourself if there is a spelling mistake in the source itself. So this is available here. Okay. Let's come to some of the features, like the artificial intelligence features that we use. Say this is one. This is if there is a commentary on this particular judgment. So this is by sir. You want to read? Can do that. Now let's come to the next one.
This is important para. So what important para does for you is it gives you the most relevant judgment for this. Say this is the judgment 2017. So this gives me the most important paragraph for this judgment. So what, how do we define the most important paragraph? It means that is this particular paragraph has been quoted in other judgments also. So let's say this one. So this is 2017 judgment. This has been cited in 2019 also. Okay, so it's giving me the list of quotable paragraphs. Now again, this judgment, let's see, this paragraph has been quoted in this other judgment. So it's giving me the list of paragraphs. Basically, these are the law points for a particular judgment. So these are very important points. That's why people are just picking it from here and putting in their judgment. Now you find like this paragraph is very relevant for me. Now I can always go on to this one and start reading this one. This might also be very helpful. So you save a lot of time and you are getting a lot of good references. Now again, this is a 2017 judgment. Often there is a query that, you know, is followed in other judgments. So basically this gives you that answer. It was followed in cited in courts 155 times. This has been cited in other cases. Now this is one case, State of Madhya Pradesh versus Honey. Now this is also giving me where exactly this was cited. So in 46 paragraph and 65 paragraph. Okay. So from here, I don't even need to open the particular judgment also. Everything is, this is being there. If you find this relevant, you can always open it. If you don't find it, you can always go on to the next one. Recently, this has been quoted. You can get from here. These are all very important features. Like, and nobody is it, in the rest of the softwares, nobody is even thinking about these things. Okay. So this is one, another feature which is very much loved by our clients. This is a case map. So basically it gives you 20 relevant judgments for a particular case. So how, this is 2017. So in this solar system of cases, these are the cases that have come before 2017. So these were referred in this. So the arrow is coming inside. So this particular case, Bachchan Singh versus State of Punjab, was discussed in Mukesh. Now this case was affirmed. Similarly, this case, Lakshman versus State of Maharashtra, was relied on. Okay.
So there were different treatment given to these particular cases in Mukesh Sharma. Okay, 2017 is now 3 years ago. What happened to Mukesh Sharma after it was delivered? So there were many cases which discussed. There is one case which affirmed this in 2019. Okay, now this particular case has also affirmed these two cases also. So you also get that kind of reference. Okay, now any case you click in the future. Okay, just. Okay, I lost your connection there. Okay, now we are back. I'm sorry for the technical glitch. Okay, let's start with this. So explaining you case map. So case map basically gives you a visualization of 20 cases that are related to a particular case. So it gives me where Mukesh Sharma was discussed, where Mukesh Sharma was affirmed. Similarly, if you're looking for, say, a dissented judgment, so if it was have been dissented somewhere, you could have always gone here and see like which where it was overruled, where it was affirmed. So all these 20 judgments will be able to see from here. Okay, let's go back. Okay, go to the top. Now, again, these are some features like if you want to take out a PDF printout with or without case note, if you want to send a mail to somebody, subscriber, non-subscriber, no problems. You just have to put in the email ID. And you will be able to send from here. It's a big judgment, therefore it's taking a little time. Let's minimize this for now. Okay, Word format. So if you want to download this in Word format, that also you can do. You can create sticky notes in this. If you want to save it in Google Drive, Dropbox, or if you want to save it in your own personal account, that you can do. If you want to save it, this document in the Manu Cloud, so that you know when you are accessing it, your office laptop or office computer, you can always go back in your home and you'll be able to find this. That also you can do. Say save it in arbitration folder. Now I can go back to arbitration folder from here. So my save docs and arbitration. There it is, Mukesh Kumar and others. Okay. So just search analytics. So now we are going to a little deeper, which is judge analytics. So this is available for all the Supreme Court judges as well as for the High Court judges. So I've done a little research for you guys if you find this helpful. So this is for Supreme Court. Show you one. So for any honorable judge sahab, you can for from Supreme Court or High Court, you can do this. This is, let me show for Mr. Sikri sir. Okay, just loaded here. So basically what this gives you is the graphical representations of the judgment that he has been writing. Okay, so let's flip it to grid. Okay, now from here you will be able to see that 2019, before retiring, he authored 15 judgments. Okay, he wrote 48 judgments. Now I want to see which are these 15 judgments that he authored. You can always click here and see the links. Okay, another one is which subject. So which subject that he basically gives his judgments on. Criminal is 86, service 50, civil, direct taxation. So if you have a like property case in front of him, so you can always go and read like a couple of his property judgments. You'll get an idea of his thinking. Okay, now let's go to the next one. This is again interesting. This is counsels that have been appearing in front of him. Okay, so Mr. B. Krishna Prasad has appeared 299 times.
in front of him. Let's go to the next one. This is judgment pronouns. So which he tends to allow, which he is given in terms, which is dismissed, which is in favor of department. So sometimes people wait, like if there is a different bench to come. So that also you can do. Okay. So again, he's citing Mr. Sinha sir. Sinha sir, he is cited 207 times. Mr. Payaz, J.C. Shah is cited 87 times. So you, if you're going in front of him, so you can always take a Sinha sir judgment. Seems true. Now, again, this is who is citing him. So P.H. Teri sir again, Delhi High Court judge. So he has cited him 280 times. Now I want to see where, which are these judgments. All the list is available to me. So all the data is available to everyone, but what we are doing is we are allowing, how we are playing with this data, and we are showing you the things that you won't see elsewhere. Okay, so this is for Supreme Court. These are the affirmed cases, discussed cases, dissented cases. So which of his cases have been affirmed by Supreme Court, other judgments. Similarly, this same database is there for the High Courts also. So you can also see there is High Court decision itself. It has been dissented for. Okay, so this was analytics. This is available right here. So just beneath Manu search, you can go and research on your favorite judge or, you know, anyone that you like. Okay, and this is there. Let's come to the profile part. This we haven't covered yesterday. So this is profile. This is if you want to change your password, that you can do. My preferences is, my preferences is basically what kind of filters do you like. So if you want, if you don't want to read ebooks, you can always unselect this. Okay. Manage search. Manage search is interesting. So let's go to Manu search and I'll do a search for you. Say order 7 rule 11A. Okay. Very simple search, but a little specific. So, okay. But by just writing order 7 rule 11A, no inverted commas, nothing, smart enough that it actually recognizes what you mean by, and it automatically takes cases where order 7 rule 11A is coming. Okay. Now I want to set an alert for this. I want to save this query first. I go here and say order 7. Now I can go from here to manage search. So here is my query, order 7. Now I can set an alert for this one. Say if I want an email alert for this, say whenever a new document comes on this particular topic, I want to be informed and doing some research on this. Say you can put an email ID, two email IDs you are allowed to put. You can give a range, like I want it for 30 days, 18 days, 16. Which system will ask you, would you like to continue with? So very good way to, you know, keep yourself updated if you're doing, if you're, some cases ongoing. It's always a good idea if some Supreme Court ruling comes on that, you'll be well aware. Okay, so this was for managed search. Now GST rate finder is there, important days, COVID-19 guidelines, every, that is available from Supreme Court and government side. Compare provisions are there. So if you want to compare, let's say, constitutions of two countries, say I'll take one India and say I'll take another Afghanistan, and I want to compare. So you can take anyone, say you can take Australia, USA, Pakistan, and I want to say what is equality in both these different constitutions. Okay, equality is here. Apparently doesn't have equality in its own, there is. Okay, so from here you can compare the constitutions a bit of two countries. If you want to read a constitution also, it's very helpful. So this is available from here. Now two acts, you can compare similarly the state acts also. Say, I want to compare Haryana Shop and Establishment Act. So this is very
important to corporates, especially in Gurgaon, and say this is, let's compare it with Delhi. Similarly, you can compare stamp duties also to different states. Say I want to compare penalties. Okay, let's select, compare apples to apples, penalties, and compare. Okay, so here you will be able to get a sense of how it is different. So from here to here. In Punjab and Haryana, this is 300 rupees for every subsequent. Here it is 250 rupees. Okay, so here, from here, you can compare two different acts, state acts. Okay, law as of, again, very, very helpful. So if you click on anyone, say, Consumer Protection Act. Consumer Protection Act 2019 has been is there. Okay. Now you can, from here, you can compare the provisions from how is it different from the 1986 one. Sometimes what happens is we only remember the section number. Say it was Section 3 was Consumer Protection, Central Consumer Protection Council here. Now it is Section 4. So just to revamp your knowledge, you can just click on this button and it will give you what has. This is available for companies like 2013 also. How is it different from 90? So any repealed act, you can compare the chart between the present one and the one that is repealed. Okay. So this is about it. Like, we have covered most of the things in the three seminars. The YouTube videos are available on our, when you'll go to YouTube, type Manu Patra, you'll find our channel there. The day before yesterday's version is also there, and yesterday's is also there. Okay, let's start with some queries. Okay, so this is, what are the Supreme Court guidelines for candidates seeking to contest elections during nominations? Okay, guidelines for candidates seeking. Okay, let's do one thing. Let's just copy this one and we can go here. Okay, now we are looking for lines, so it always makes sense to just select Supreme Court here, otherwise it will also show us tribunals. And let's go to Manu Search. Okay, now we usually don't suggest it, that like the queries, but our system is intuitive enough that it is able to all the, like what you are saying. So you don't need to necessarily use Boolean search. You can use Boolean search, but you necessarily don't have to. So I'm just writing guidelines for candidates seeking to contest elections nomination. So the entire thing I've pasted there. So from here you can see that different citations. So this particular judgment was 6 times cited, this particular 3 times. So this is the more cited cases on the same topic. That's why it's probably appearing in the top. So let's open this one. You can always read the head note also. If you know, if you feel like you don't want to open it first, you read the case note here, or the acts citing references, which decisions which apparently have relied on 23 decisions that you can see. If you want to take out a printout of this, you know, just give it to a senior before. So you can always do that. Open this judgment, just click on to this one. Now we are, no, here I saw one link. Okay, so this is 170th report, so that is also hyperlinked. Okay, so nowhere else you will find this, that, you know, both the primary and secondary. Primary is like the judgments, the Ware Acts. The secondary is like these kind of committee reports, so those are also available to you right in one place. Let's go back to the judgment. Let's move to the top. Okay, so this is the judgment. Okay, it has one important para also. I guess you recall from 15 minutes ago. So this is, gives me the most quoted paragraph from the judgment. Okay, okay, this is the 56th paragraph, and I guess it's
same as necessary. Okay, so this is our para. So this is like what we were looking for. So just to show you how you can use important para, you know, you don't have to necessarily read the entire statement first. If you're in a hurry, you can just go to this, click this button, and the possibility is very high that you will find the paragraph which you're looking for, because all the relevant paragraphs are available here. Okay, so this is how we get to these guidelines. So you keep getting these kind of questions, guidelines for child labor, guidelines for this. Okay, now this is, I'm looking for a recent judgment on IPR, and under that subject need to identify cases dealing with infringement. Okay, let's copy infringement and let's go to legal search. Okay, so legal search, how different is it from Manu search? Legal search basically gives you subject-wise judgments. Okay, subject-wise, if you have a particular, we have created all these tables for you so that, you know, if you want to say negotiable instruments act 138, so there you have to type the entire thing. Here you just have to press NI and it will automatically ask you which section you want to fill in. So this is more helpful if you have a specific thing in mind. Subject wise is also there. So 50 categorization we do. So again, this is we are the only one that who is doing this. So intellectual property is one of those. So intellectual properties, all the judgments are classified under this. Just select the intellectual property and make a search. Okay. Now what I can do is I can just select newest from here. The Z coming. Now I can search in results. So infringement I want to see. So I can always refine this from here. These are all the IPR decisions that are dealing with infringement. So if you're looking for a specific subject, it's always recommended to go through this. So if arbitration case, it was sometimes, you know, you hear it in a newspaper that some arbitration case has come recently. So you can always select arbitration, select the newest. You'll probably get to that judgment. Let's go to the next one. This is violation right, visitation right of father to his children in case of non-payment of maintenance. Okay, visitation right of father to his children in case of payment, non-payment of maintenance. Okay, so let's use Manu search for this. Okay, so I'll show you one thing. Like, this is probably the, if you want to use search and result, those kind of things, say I'm using visitation, right? I know this particular judgment is on visitation, right? So this is something I'm very sure that visitation rights is there, because the whole judgment is based on this. So we suggest that you basically start with your broader query. So if I just write visitation rights, I put them in phrase. This is all the judgments where visitation rights is coming. I can see. I can always write it visiting rights also from here. Okay, so visiting rights, I think, is there, and I can always write visitation both. These are the two, you know, and I can select or. Both of things, either visiting rights or I can select. So now 149 judgments were there. Okay, just I go back and write visiting rights. Hope the spelling is correct. Okay, so from here you can always search in results. So whichever topic that you want, say no maintenance paid. Maintenance paid. I can do a near each other on this one, or say certain results. So I can always refine this. Okay. So I was confused where I was going wrong. The problem is that I have selected Supreme Court and I completely forgot about that. So you can just deselect Supreme Court from here. So it was only looking in this. Now we can always come back and make our search. Now, you know, the search result is much more, 283 results from here. And now you can search in results, say no maintenance paid. You can do a near each other on this one. Near each other is basically, the system will look for these three words in a range of 20 words. Okay. And you can refine it from here. Okay. Now, these are the judgments. 51 judgments that might be relevant for me. Okay, there is this new button that is there. So anytime a new button is there, should be a little curious. So this is basically telling me that an SLP is pending on this particular case. So this is Manu Goyal versus Aditi Goyal. And from here only most of the judgments are open. So it's very ideally placed so that you cannot miss this. From here, if you see, you go to the judgment. So wherever an SLP is pending or an SLP was dismissed, you would be made aware of that. So I get this 54. These are the pending SLP numbers. Okay. Similarly, for this one, this is SLP is disposed of. So this is only Manu Patra is providing. So this kind of research nobody does. Most of the people are just providing the printouts and you just submit it in the court. So we go a little farther than that. Okay, let's come to our next query. This we are done. Let's see. Okay, so CRPC, we are looking for two acts, CRPCs and both. Okay, so if you are doing a section search, suggest that you use legal search, and you can from here do a two search at one time. Say I want to use NI and 138, and this is CRPC 178. Okay, I will make my search. Okay, so here all the decisions where both NI and CRPC are being used, that you can see from here. Okay, since we are here and I just remembered something, there is a relevant section search also in Manu Patra. What is a relevant section search? So basically in this one we give, if you want judgments based on a particular section only, so all the judgments which are actually based on 138. Okay, so these are the like 5-6 acts which were used, but this judgment was actually based on Negotiation Instruments Act 138. Okay, so this is all available. So this is like from here you can see, this is again our editorial team's doing. Everything is available from here. Okay, let's go to the next one. Okay, my client Ms. Reena Jain, who seeks compassionate appointment in the place of her father, a government servant dying in harness. Her plea was rejected on the grounds that dying in harness rules 1974 does not allow divorced daughters as family find relevant judgments to help her. It will give you 1 minute to read this. Okay, let's start. Dying in harness. Okay, so the rules, notification, bare acts, everything is available. So you don't have to go elsewhere to find any of these things. So we in legal search, we have a rule search also. Say I want to select for dying in harness. So this is Uttar Pradesh dying in harness. Now I want to look for, say, definition. Okay. Other. Say definition. Say what is a family according to dying in harness? Okay, so this is there. On this is rule 2. Okay, so this is there. Family includes the following relations of the deceased government servant: wife, husband, sons, daughter. Okay. So the divorced daughter clearly is not mentioned here. So we'll have to go to the search. So is there any judgment that is there for this? Say, I'll write my appointment for divorced daughter. So, not using any inverted commas, anything right now. Okay. Spelling mistake over there somewhere. Okay, so this is the first judgment, Patna High Court, 2001. So I don't want to read the judgment. I can just see the case note from here. So case note act. So here there is no, okay, held in every case of death of government in harness, it may not be possible to appoint one of the dependents. There is no vested right to compassionate appointment. Okay, here she has been denied the compassionate appointment. This is a Patna High Court judgment, 2001. Let's go to this. Is again dining in rules. A divorced daughter dependent upon her father continue to be the liability of her father has to be included within the meaning of the family. Okay, so this is in our favor. This is petition allowed. This is a 2001 judgment from Allahabad High Court. I can also see from here is that this judgment was cited in 6 other judgments. So I just open this one. And this is here, everything. I showed you this feature. This is cited in para. So this basically gives me where this was quoted. So recently this judgment was quoted in a 2019 judgment. Two judgments from 2019 have quoted this. So these are the 6 other judgments that you can look into. So these are more, these would be helpful. If you go to any one of these, you'll be able to find. So we started with one judgment. We found it easily and we have got like 6-7 judgments to read on the same topic. Okay. So this was for compassionate appointment for divorced daughter. Let's go to the next one. This is stamp duty, stamp fee for Delhi. Okay. So how do I find the stamp fee for Delhi under the company current Stamp Duty Act? So for that, you can go to legal search. There's an act search available here. Just write stamp duty. Stamp will be sufficient. Stamp Act, and you can write Delhi here. Sometimes we get calls for these things, like how do we get there? In just everything is available here. Legal search, basically. Stamp fees, you can see from here. Okay, let's go to next one. Okay, so citation search is also very comprehensive. This is CTR 47, 1985. Okay. So the citation search is available right here. So the journals that we cover, these are like 320 odd journals. If you want to check, you can always check also which journal that we are covering or not. This is a current tax reporter, CTR. So you can just select CTR. I'll just check for the 1985-47 volume. Okay, so everything is given to you from in a tabular format, so you don't need to remember any formulas. Like different search engines have these things that you have to particularly look for a file. Volume number 45 and the page number was, okay, it is 47 and 126. 47 and 126. You can make your search. Okay, so even if I didn't put in 126, I didn't remember 126, you can always make your search and it will give you the entire 47 volume. So even if you have a partial citation, that will also do. Make my search. Okay, this is the judgment. Okay, so this is how you can get, if you're reading an article and you come across a citation, you just have the citation only. You'll be easily able to get to the judgment. Okay.
This is there. Now I'm an insolvency advocate. What is the primary and secondary data available to me? Let's go to Manupatra. Manupatra, there's a perception that we do, but we have a lot of other things also. Say, business policy. So in business policy, we have all the secondary and primary data regarding any particular subject. Say, insolvency, we have a folder for this. So as insolvency, all the acts, rules, guidelines, all the secondary data regulations, so this is all available to me from here. So anything I want to get myself updated on, that also I can do. Similarly, this is available for real estate also. So this is, you know, any new press releases that is coming out, any new reports that is coming out, so very frequently updated. So just to keep yourself updated from here, it's very easy on your any subject of law that you want to go. So arbitration is also there. If I'm a company lawyer, corporate law is also there. Acts, rules, all the due diligence. So we have around a lot of corporate lines which are very fond of this. Okay. Let's go to the next one, which is how do I check the date of enforcement? Consumer Protection Act 2019, is it notified or not? So there we have a Bare Act folder available here. So if you want to see this kind of information about any Bare Act, if you want to read, so you just have to click on these buttons. So this is plus signs, just to open this one till you find a hyperlink. Once you get to the hyperlink, you can click on that one. So we have organized it differently, chronological, alphabetical, subject wise. So I'll click on the alphabetical wise and I can click on all. So from here, you can find all the acts. Say this is Aadhaar Act 2016. This is the amendment. So we also provide the amendment as well as the act. And in the main act, everything that is amended as per today, this will be as per today. Okay, so we're looking for consumer protection. Okay, so this is Consumer Protection Act 2019, and it says its date of enforcement is still to be notified. Okay, so this is everything has been passed on this one, but the date of enforcement is yet to be there. This is a very useful small information that whenever you're going to the court, you should be aware of this. This is there. Similarly, for the same act, you can see it in a single document from here. You can, if you want to read particular rules on this one, that also you can do. Is a comparison provision that I showed you earlier. So if there's a bill pending on this one, that also you can see. The entire act is available to you from here. This is section wise. If you want to read the commentary on that particular section that is there, we have covered this in the first session. Just going through it again. Okay. So this is about it. So encourage you to ask questions if you have any. We can discuss on that. Stop sharing. Vishwanath, if you have any questions, I can be happy to answer. Okay, no questions. So we have this contact. So if you have any queries, any suggestions, we in the pre-COVID days, we used to have these sessions in different law schools also. So if you have a future that you can do, if you have any suggestions regarding Manupatra, if you're finding anything difficult, or even if you want to send your articles on this, we'll be happy to help you out. So you can always reach out to us at contact@manupatra.com. Thank you for being here.